stated how in some ways the prison system's gone backwards, and she talked about in her early days visiting Arahata and some of the other prisons, how they had a really open community-based approach and the success she saw in that.
One of them was definitely the huge statistic that was that 93% of women who are in prisons have a history of sexual abuse.
I really enjoyed hearing, I think, Mary talk, her personal experience of working in prisons and with prisoners. I think it's good to get some hands-on experience with people actually have been there, done it, seen it for themselves. That would have been definitely a highlight.
I think for me one of the biggest things was actually the lack of rehabilitation programs specifically tailored for women.
It was surprising and disturbing to hear the comment that for some women, the first night they sleep in prison is the first night they say they felt safe sleeping in their lives.
So what I was thinking during the forum is that often we make a lot of judgments instantly about people who are in prison, who are in the prison system. And I guess two things that I think we don't think about enough about women prisoners that come up in this are firstly who they are and the backgrounds they come from. And I think often it's really hard to be really punitive and really critical of these people when actually you don't know why they commit what they commit.
Touched upon this idea that there's some self-care units in Tawa, but now that women who go there can't have their babies with them where they used to be able to when they were in prison just because the facilities aren't up to par, it's a simple thing that we can look at addressing.
And it seems ridiculous, I don't know what the reasons are, that the money can be found to ferry a woman to Christchurch but not for child, for doing basic childproofing on accommodation.
Fascinating topic, a topic with a lot of misconceptions and a variety of people in the room, from no knowledge but interested and sensitive to the issues to working on the front line. So I think it's just kind of like a little hub of learning.
No, I think it's fantastic. I think keeping on bringing together people who are the combination of young, enthusiastic people who, by dint of fortune, life experiences to this, they haven't got huge amounts of practical experience with the criminal justice system, and bringing them together with more older, more experienced people who have had lives dealing in that area is a really fruitful combination. And to combine that youthful energy with some knowledge and experience is going to lead to good things.
Yeah, it was really good to be in a circle of like, interactive people and talk about real issues that really affect our world today. Everybody's got a different point of view, which is really interesting, so you always get like a range of opinions, range of new information that you hadn't even heard or thought about before, so it's always good.
This is only our second forum, and already I'm just like really excited and being really engaged on the past two forums.
It was a lot less formal than I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be a bit of a lecture and sit down and and listen and shut up and do what you're told, but I do enjoy the interaction. I really enjoyed the give and take nature of the events.
I think it is okay to come in not knowing, but that's huge, that there isn't this big wall that to come to a JustSpeak event you have to know about women in prisons. And so it's okay to come and say, I don't know, but I want to.
I think if young people are informed, they will then take that information and make wise decisions with it. I think people who are informed and care about issues will then act accordingly, and my hope is that that will lead to better support in those environments.
I think walking into a room of about 100 people is always pretty amazing, really. A lot of people who come to the forum say it's amazing how many young people are interested, which is great. But then I think it's kind of a sad thing that our society is so surprised that youth are engaged and interested. So I think we really need to get out there and show the world that we are. And I think a lot of what that is for me is going out there and doing practical work. So JustSpeak also writes policy, we write press releases, we do outreach in schools, we do all of these things. And I guess it will just be getting more and more people who come along to those